Now, in order to limit the amount of contention on the network when a lock is released, we're going to do something that we often do in real life, procrastination. So basically, the idea is the following. Each processor is going to delay asking for the lock, even though they observe that the lock is released. They're not going to immediately go and try to get the lock. They're going to wait for a little bit of time. It's sort of like what happens at rush hour. If you find that this traffic is too much, you might decide that I don't want to get on the highway right now. I'm going to delay a little bit so that I don't have to spend as much time on the highway. So that's sort of the same thing that is being proposed here. And this is what is called spin lock with delay. Let's discuss two different delay alternatives. In the first one, you're here, you found that you did not get the lock, and therefore you're here locally spinning in your cache, waiting for the lock to be released. Normally what you would have done when the lock is released is go back out, break out of this loop, and go back and check if you can get the lock again. But what we're going to do is, instead of doing that, when we break out of this loop, meaning that the lock has been released, I'm not going to immediately go and check to see if I can get the lock. I'm going to delay myself by a certain amount of time. And you notice that the delay is conditioned by what processor ID I have. So every processor is waiting for a different amount of delay in order to contend for the lock. So since the delay is being chosen differently for each processor, even though all of them notice that the lock has been released simultaneously, only one of them will go and check it. And so we are sort of sequentializing the order in which the processors that are waiting for the lock are going to check whether the lock is available. So that is one possible scheme for delaying. Now, the problem with this is it's a static delay, right? So every processor has been pre-assigned a certain amount of delay, which means that even if the lock is available, I may not immediately go and check because my delay may be very high compared to some other processor. And that's always an issue when you have static decision making. What we can do is instead make the decision dynamically. And what we're going to do is, when we notice that we don't have the lock, we're going to delay ourselves by a certain amount of time before we try for the lock again. You notice that if you're going to delay checking for whether I have the lock or not, it's not super critical that you spin locally or go to memory. But in this example, I'm making it very simple by saying that if you don't get the lock, just delay a little bit before you try for this lock again. And the idea here is this delay is some small number to start with. But suppose I go and check and I find it again to be locked. Then what I'm going to do is the next time around, I'm going to increase the delay. That's why it's called exponential backoff. So I'm increasing the delay, doubling the amount of delay that I'm going to do, so that the next time, if I don't find the lock to be available, I delay by twice the amount from the previous time. And this is essentially saying that when the lock is not highly contended for, I'm not going to delay myself too much. I'm going to immediately go and get it. But on the other hand, if I go back again and again, and every time I go and check, I find it is locked, I'm going to increase the amount of delay, because that's saying that a lot of people are contending for the lock at the same time. And therefore, in order to make sure that we are being sensitive to the contention that is there for the lock, we increase the amount of delay that we are experiencing. Now, one nice thing about this simple algorithm that I've shown you is that I'm not using the caches at all. And if the processor happens to be a non-cache coherent multiprocessor, this algorithm will still work, because we're always using test and set and not using just loading from the memory. Because if it is not a cache coherent multiprocessor, your private cache is not going to be coherent with respect to memory. And so you have to execute test and set, but you don't want to do it all the time. And the delay makes sure that you can reduce the amount of contention on the network. Generally speaking, if there is a lot of contention, then static assignment of delay may be better than this dynamic exponential backoff. But in general, any kind of delay, any kind of procrastination will help a lock algorithm better than the naive spin lock that we talked about.